Hey guys, Coach here. Hey, I'm really excited to bring you this week's plan of the week because this one I know a whole lot about from personal experience. You know, when we had Weed Patch Ranch, we had over 90 of these particular plants, and we had the greatest reputation for producing a product that all of our family and friends just craved. They could not get enough of it. This week's plant of the week is the Frantoio olive tree. Now, I said I had 90 of them, and 90 of them was a lot for one hombre to take care of. And I did a whole lot of care, especially when we first got Weed Patch, to getting them back in shape because they were grown without any irrigation for years and years, so they were kind of stunted. But the Frantoio olive tree is one that is considered one of the premier olive oil producing olive trees in the world. They can grow unattended to 30 feet tall. I found them very manageable, somewheres between 12 to 20 feet tall. But the oil that these guys produced, oh my gosh, it was the butteriest, most earthiest taste you ever want to experience. And we had upwards of 50 gallons a year off of 90 trees. The Frantoio olive is a wonderful tree to have as a producer, obviously, but also as a standalone olive tree. If you don't mind harvesting the olives, having just one of them probably won't give you a lot of oil or a lot of berries, but if you had, say, like three in the yard, you could have enough where you can make yourself a few gallons of olive oil every single fall and winter. We used to always harvest in November, right around Thanksgiving. That's when things ripened up. They do not like super cold climates. This is a tree where you're gonna wanna have them in zones 10 and 11. We were in zone 9 where we were in the Central Valley, and they did fine. They can even go to zone 8 without any problems. Pruning every year seemed to give them that beautiful multi-trunk olive tree type of shape. So if you're up in Minnesota, if you're up in Montana, that kind of area, this one would not be for you in the wintertime unless you had it in a big box specimen that you could bring into a heated greenhouse during the wintertime. But for all of us down in the mid and southern tier states, Frantoio olive, fantastic. You can mix them with Arbequina olives, you can mix them with Mission olives if you want to have a different selection of fruit in the harvest season. Mission olives are bigger, Arbequinas are smaller, but Arbequinas are an olive oil producing olive tree as well. But Frantoio olive, I couldn't believe I found one out here at the retail nursery, and I wanted to share it with you because we know so much about them. But check them out next time you're at your mom and pop nurseries, especially in the mid states and more southern states. Texas is a big place, Southern California, Arizona, those places have these quite a few places, so check them out. Hey, this is Coach bringing you the Frantoio olive tree for this week's plant of the week. I'll catch you next week. I appreciate you staying with me. Check out some of the other videos and give me a thumbs up once in a while. I really appreciate it. You guys take care.